gotta be the one who prays on time, who lives right every day.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Nature is beautiful. Imagine Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who created the nature in its best possible form. The most blissful and joyful moment for Jannati would be the view of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about the believers, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَشَدُّ حُبَّ لِلَّهِ, that believers are the one who love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala most intensely. For us to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have to follow the footsteps of Rasulullah. If you want to become the beloved of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ. That if you want to become the beloved of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you have to follow the footsteps of Rasulullah. Just like one of the poets beautifully said, نقشِ قدم نبی کے ہیں جنت کے راستے, اللہ سے ملاتے ہیں سنت کے راستے. Translation, کیسے کروں؟ Meaning that the footsteps of Rasulullah will take you to the Jannah. And if a person wants to reach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has to follow the Sunnah. For us to inculcate the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and love of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there are two major ways. One is the sohbah of Salihin, which is the company of the righteous people. Second is juhud in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, striving in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Any virtual platform can never be a true replacement of any sohbah of Salihin, company of righteous people. One of my teachers used to give a beautiful example. He would say that if a person has spent a few minutes or maybe a minute in the company of Rasulullah, we would call him a Sahabi. And if a person has a connection with Rasulullah by any other medium but has not attended any of his majlis or his company, we would not call him a Sahabi. But the correct use of social media, whether it's YouTube or Facebook, can still make a change, can still influence other people if we are sincere and follow the path of Rasulullah. And that's why I want to use this medium to empower myself and others with the teaching of Rasulullah. Keep watching. Our kids are the future of Islam. It is our responsibility being a Muslim parent to raise our kids in a way that they develop confidence and conviction in their deen. It is my intention to produce such content that will encourage our kids to practice our beautiful deen with full confidence. With your support, I want to start an interactive quiz show that will allow our kids to engage with other Muslim kids and will also help them to create a zeal about learning Islam. So if you're a parent and would like your kid to participate in the quiz show, please email me at tazkirunlimited@gmail.com or contact me at Facebook. And for smaller kids, I would like to start a series of stories that will inspire our kids to become like Sahabi or Sahabiya. Stay tuned and keep watching. Consistency is very important in our deen. It comes in the narration of Rasulullah ﷺ that the most beloved deed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that is done on constant and regular basis, even if it is little. I want to start a series of topics that deals with the life of Rasulullah ﷺ so that we can learn how we can implement the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in different faculties of life. Whether you are a businessman or a professional or a student, we need to learn that how we can implement the life of Rasulullah ﷺ in different faculties of life. For that, I need your support. Also, a lot of people have asked me that what is the meaning of tazkir and why did I choose it? So the meaning of tazkir is powerful reminder, just like tazkira. Tazkira means the highest form of reminder. So I picked Tazkir Unlimited so that our message of reminder can be spread unlimitedly without any limits. And on a side note, when you're searching for Tazkir Unlimited, make sure you put TADHKIR. Keep watching. You must have heard the name Abu Hurairah. Yes, I'm talking about the famous Sahabi Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who narrated thousands of hadith from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. His real name was Abdul Shams. Prophet sallallahu alaihi changed his name to Abdul Rahman, and later he got a nickname, Abu Hurairah. A lot of people know about Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, but very few people know about the person who brought him into the full Islam. His name was Tufail al-Daws radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Tufail al-Daws radiallahu ta'ala anhu became Muslim in the earlier part of the Meccan period. And when he went back to Yemen to work on his people, to call people towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he brought one person to Prophet ﷺ after some time. And his name was Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu. We saw that how Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu became a reason and a source to preserve so many hadith from Rasulullah ﷺ. And behind him, there was a very unknown sahabi, Tufail al-Daws radiallahu ta'ala anhu. For carry out the work of deen and the effort of deen, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can use anyone. It could be you or I. For this reason, I request you to subscribe to the channel of Tazkir Unlimited and follow the page on Facebook as well. For us to carry out the work of Deen, we can support each other. Whether you live in US, UK, Middle East or Asia, you can spread the words of Khair by sitting at home. Follow the channel and stay tuned for more videos. Until my next video, Assalamu alaikum. Muhammadan Rasulullah.